Problem 28 on the practice test measures your understanding of the AND, OR, and biconditional operators used in Boolean logic. The question seeks to find the correct truth table for this expression, which uses the Boolean values P and Q. To correctly evaluate this expression, we need to remember the meanings of these operators, where the first part of the expression represents P and Q, the conjunction operator, and the second part represents P or Q, called disjunction. It then combines these results of the two parts using the biconditional operator, which is stated using the phrase if and only if. We'll use this truth table to work through the problem. Pause the video for a moment and create this table on a sheet of paper. Now let's work through each column. The R column will represent the conjunction P and Q. And as you learned in a previous lesson, in order for AND to be true, both parts must be true. The only line that fits this requirement is the first one, where P and Q are both true. And so you mark a 1 in the box for true. The remaining three combinations are all false, since at least one of the values is false, making the entire expression false. Now let's evaluate the OR column. Think about it for a moment and fill out the column on your table. Okay, let's see how you did. Since OR requires only one of the values to be true, the first three lines of this column are all true, with only the last line false, since both values are false. The final step is to compare the results of R and S to see if they meet the biconditional operator requirements. Recall from the lesson that the phrase if and only if is true when both parts are true as well as when both parts are false. With that in mind, take a moment and fill out the final column. Let's check it out. The two values to compare are in columns R and S, and the combinations that fit the criteria are in the first line, where both values are true, and in the last line, where both are false. That makes the final result, as you can see here, true, false, false, true, going down the column. Now let's look at the four choices and find the one that matches. Choice A does not match at all, and as you can see, is the exact opposite of your answer. Choice C is a little better, but still not correct. Choice D is almost correct, but the last row is different. Choice B is clearly a match and is the correct answer.